Imagine if you could build your own gun as easily as you could copy a document.
Yeah, it sounds like something in the movies. And it's getting, and it gets even scarier because these would-be weapons might slip past metal detectors. Our crime and justice correspondent Joe Johns explains.
At this Northern Virginia gun store, you can buy all sorts of weapons. But what if you could make weapons like these in your own home using what's called a three-dimensional printer? Sounds like science fiction, but to some, it's not so far-fetched. Take this recent episode of CSI.
Primarily, 3D printers are used to manufacture parts for antique cars and design prototypes.
And you think our killer printed a gun?
Multiple guns. Identical, disposable, untraceable.
And it could also be undetectable. 3D printers like this make solid objects from digital models and plans. And what's manufactured could be all plastic, like this little gadget with all these moving parts that work together perfectly. So a plastic gun manufactured with this technology might not necessarily be picked up by your garden variety metal detector at an airport or public building. It's a potential game changer in the gun control debate.
We're trying to produce guns with this technology.
Advocates of the so-called printable gun, like University of Texas student Cody Wilson, see it as a rights issue.
I believe in the universal access to arms, and I want to show you, as far as it's possible for me, that this thing will be completely unable to be regulated.
He's behind Defense Distributed, a nonprofit organization dedicated to creating what Wilson calls the Wiki Weapon, a firearm with a design that can be distributed on the Internet and manufactured using a 3D printer. He's already built part of an AR-15 using the technology. Democratic Congressman Steve Israel has taken notice.
I just want to make it impossible for people to use three-dimensional printers to manufacture gun components, which they was done, and in fact, six bullets were fired from one of these components.
That's why Congressman Israel is pushing to renew the Undetectable Firearms Act, a law passed a quarter of a century ago banning plastic firearms that will expire next year.
It just defies common sense, safety, and logic to make it easier for terrorists and criminals to manufacture the components of guns which can be brought onto our airplanes and into our federal buildings.
The National Rifle Association says it views this legislation as unnecessary. Pro-gun advocates say to date, no one using a 3D printer has manufactured a working firearm completely out of plastic. One 3D printing expert says it might not even be possible anytime soon.
I don't feel like this technology is going to be there next year, but in my estimation, we have some time and ways to go to get there.
And Wilson worries about the chilling effect on new ideas.
What does Mr. Israel say? Well, we should prevent the development of a whole branch of technology. Well, that's ridiculous.
The other issue here is whether an attempt to stop people from making plastic guns could turn into an attempt by government to regulate use of 3D printers, potentially raising a question of censorship. Congressman Israel's office says he is not proposing anything that would regulate the printers themselves. Fascinating story.
Really? I had no idea about that.
Yeah. Fascinating. Joe-